Cool. Now, here's a question for you. Who do you think has the top-selling Australian record ever? All right, here's the answer. Soñaba un mundo senza più violenza. How about that? Anthony Callea's version of The Prayer is the top-selling song in Australian history, and he will be here at our location in Bourke Street about 20 minutes from now. And he's got a few fans who've been waiting since before daylight this morning to see him with news about his latest CD.
And I thought they were waiting for us, Tress.
No, you did, actually.
Here we are at Bourke Street Mall. We have a very, very, very special guest with us this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Anthony Callea. Anthony, nice to see you. He's doing that initiation thing that we like to do here at the Today Show. If you're going to come on and talk about your new single, you've got to hand out some pink Krispy Kremes. It's just the way it works around here. Hey, listen, we're going to be talking to Anthony very shortly, but first a reminder on how you can be a big winner and go and see Cirque du Soleil.
It's like stepping...
Well, he mightn't have won last year's Australian Idol, but that didn't stop him achieving an all-time record of having the biggest-selling single in Australian recording history. Anthony Callea, good to see you, mate.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm terrific, thank you. Thanks for coming down here. It's
Not a problem. Nice
to have you with us. How did you feel, and how were you told that you'd been responsible for the highest-selling single in the country?
Oh, it's absolutely brilliant to know that your debut single has, achieved that, and... It's quite exciting. It's one of those feelings that you sort of can't really explain, and it's sort of going to be a hard one to follow.
It is, man. It's all downhill from there, I tell you what. Fantastic. I mean, Australian Idol was such a great success. You were there when it was just you and Casey at the end.
Yep.
The two of you there. Did you think, got this in the bag?
No, not at all. Myself and Casey sort of weren't even thinking about that throughout the whole day, and we're just enjoying the day. Like, I had a ball that day. It was the best day of my life.
In hindsight, it was, because it's all turned out pretty well. It must have been disappointing, though, at that moment.
At the time, because you go through all of that, and, you know, naturally you are a little bit disappointed. But, you know, I had the best time of my life, and I just knew that I had to sort of somehow continue that.
Rolling on from this, I mean, how has Idol changed your life? Obviously, you're a very different person now than you were 12 months ago.
Oh, in a way, but at the end of the day, I'm still the same sort of person, just with a busier schedule and doing something that I absolutely love and being recognised for that. And, yeah, it's the best job you could ever have.
Well, being recognised is the key, I suppose, because now you can't walk down the street without... Walk down the street?
Absolutely. I try and do all the normal things.
You've just got a crowd of kids following you these days.
Sometimes, yeah. But it's all good.
You've got the double A-sided single coming up, Bridge Over Troubled Waters, another... cover version of another classic song. Tell us about the decision to do that.
Yeah, this time we're releasing a double A, which is Rain and Bridge Over Troubled Water. And Rain is more of a soft rock contemporary pop song, and Bridge Over Troubled Water is a song that sort of captures another moment from the show which people can relate to. So I thought it'd be a good idea to sort of do the two at the same time.
People who are in the situation, you've got enormous instant kind of fame through a television show like this, are faced with an enormous challenge of turning this into a long-time career. How are you kind of working through that? And who are you listening to? Who are you taking advice from?
You know, I have a team of people working with me, and, you know, I always listen to their advice. And, you know, sometimes you can't do everything that they say, but just take on what they say and just consider it. And, and just sort of take each day as it comes and go with the flow and try and make the right decisions. At the end of the day, you're not going to make the right decisions all the time, but... You know, learn from your mistakes and...
You can't afford too many mistakes, though, can you? I mean, there are a lot of people who've had spectacular success and then have put the wrong foot in the wrong place and it's kind of taken a little bit away. I mean, you know, who do you trust ultimately? Yourself, I guess.
Yeah, I think you have to just go with your own instinct and your gut feeling. Usually that's the right one.
Yeah. Do you have a career path set out for you? I mean, are you looking at the next 5, 10 years and saying, this is where I want to be at that time?
At this stage, I just want to get the album out and take it from there. It's a bit hard to sort of plan things when your album hasn't actually been released yet. So, at the end of this month, really sit down and sort of work out exactly what's going to happen.
I think it's a pretty safe bet the album's going to go okay.
Hopefully.
Touring? You want to do more touring throughout the year?
Yeah. In May, I'll be doing some shows in Sydney and Melbourne. And then, hopefully, in July, I'll be doing a national tour around Australia.
And then I guess the next challenge is to try and go offshore and take your talent overseas.
That would be the ultimate.
Yeah. Well, Anthony, you're a lovely bloke. We've always enjoyed having you on the show. We love Anthony, don't we?
Yeah.
Think he's doing okay?
Yeah, very good.
The album's out at the end of the month. The single's out this week,
Sunday,
right?
Sunday, yep.
Terrific. We wish you luck, mate.
Thanks so much.
Thank you very much indeed. We're going to get you... Would you like to get a CD from Anthony?
Yeah!
Personally autographed?
Yeah!
With a bonus Krispy Kreme? Thanks for coming on. Nice. We got some there for you.
Cool.
Just don't rough him up too much, all right? Thanks for coming on, mate.
Not a problem.
Thank you for that. Hey, listen, we've got a competition running here on the Today Show.
So nice. Give
you the chance to see one of the all-time greats live in concert. Bette Midler is coming to get into it. Good luck, and thanks for the people who already have. Once again, thanks to Anthony for Callea for coming down, and back to you guys.
Thanks, Dickie.
You really do know how to work a crowd, Dickie.
Some of those girls dragged their poor, long-suffering mothers out of bed at about 5 o'clock this morning to get them in here to see Anthony Callea. So go the mothers.
Exactly. Well, coming up in about 20 minutes, we're going to talk to Gian Rooney and Grant Hackett about the upcoming national swim titles.
We're also going to be hitting the week's hot issues with our radio buddies in Sydney and Brisbane, so stay with us here on Today.